It takes only a 10-minute drive from Stockholm before you hit the vast Swedish forest. Sweden is the fifth largest country in Europe, and half of it is covered by trees. Spending time out in nature is part of the culture, and mushroom picking is what every Swede does at the end of the summer or early autumn.
I think I've got lucky. Look, two little golden dots. That looks like a chanterelle to me. It's not going to make much of a meal. They're very small. Look at that, tiny. Oh, well. It's a start.
Growing up mushroom foraging means that most Swedes know which mushrooms are edible. Otherwise, the old rule applies. Don't pick it if you don't know if it's safe to eat. The few mushrooms I've found will be the base for my main dish, mushroom risotto. Time for a little break. I brought some pea soup along. Typical Swedish pea soup. Don't forget the Swedish mustard. Essential. A good squeeze. I'm using a sweet Swedish mustard, which isn't very spicy.
Trust me, it tastes really good. You might not always be successful in the forest, but you can always just enjoy just being here.
To take the time to enjoy nature or stay a few days in a countryside cabin is very Scandinavian. And mushroom picking is just as much about being outdoors as it is about finding anything edible. A full basket or an empty one really doesn't matter. This recipe is loosely inspired by a northern Swedish dish called pulsa. I don't know if I'm saying that right. It's a pearl barley porridge topped with crispy mince and beetroot and a fried egg. So I've taken a little bit of inspiration by using pearl barley, which I'm going to toast. And you're just toasting it to release the lovely nutty flavours. Meantime, I'm going to chop up onion. This is the bit where I get emotional over cooking. Now for the carrot. The carrot and the onion is going to form the base for your risotto. It's definitely smoking, and you can actually see the pearl barley is starting to toast really nicely. You just want a light brown colour, and then you can also smell. It smells a bit like popcorn. You only want to soften your onions at this point. It's not about caramelising them. And once the onions are soft, you can add your carrots. They go in. A generous amount of allspice. Give it a little stir. You can smell the allspice. Pearl barley goes in too. Give that a good stir. And then I'm going to add some stock. You can use vegetable stock or chicken stock. Give it a very gentle stir to check there's nothing sticking on the bottom. And then you can just leave it to simmer away. The pearl barley will absorb the stock. You don't have to do any stirring. It's a bit of a lazy risotto. Well, actually, don't tell the Italians. It's not even risotto. Leave to simmer for 20 minutes or until the pearl barley is tender, and top with extra stock if it dries up.
My risotto is actually finished. The stock has been absorbed. You can see it's got like this lovely creamy texture. Before I finish it off, I need to fry some chanterelle. Ooh,
While that's cooking, I'm going to finish off the risotto. Little sour cream adds an extra level of richness, but also a tiny acidic note. Give it a taste, always important. A tad more salt. Parsley, always good with a bit of green and freshness. Check on the mushrooms. I think the mushrooms are done. You don't want to overcook them, otherwise they go mushy, soggy. Right. This risotto base is great to top with anything you might have in the fridge. So if you had some crispy bacon, you could add some roasted vegetables. It's really very adaptable. So this is my favorite Swedish cheese. It's Västerbotten. Kind of similar to mature cheddar, a hard cheese. It's got a lot of flavor, quite salty, delicious. And a touch of parsley. My little taste of the forest, a toasted barley and mushroom risotto. We can fly.